On Monday's special tonight, we're looking at Western Kenya politics. We're just going to draw your attention real quick to a poll. The question we've been asking you is, Ababu Namwamba the next kingpin of Luhya land? You're sending in your responses quick and fast, and we'll be sampling them at the end of this broadcast. But joining us now is Ayub Savula, who is the Member's Parliament for Lugari, and you're welcome to the program. Let's start by getting your own assessment of your colleague here. What do you think of his political turnaround and the chances of him regaining his seat now that he has declared his support for President Uhuru Kenyatta?
First of all, I'll congratulate my colleague for actually taking an initiative to participate freely in politics in Belangi and select a political party of his choice, because it's a democratic right as envisaged in the constitution. But having said that, I would like to caution my brother or give him a word of advice. In Luhya land, we have a proverb that says a child grows among others. If a child grows alone, he might become a social misfit. In Western Kenya, the main dominant political force is ODM, ANC, Ford Kenya. It was my wish that my brother could have joined one of those forces to make a political impact in the next general election.
But right now he's a misfit, an outcast.
Politically, if you associate yourself with Jubilee in Western, you look at numbers. Just send anybody there to do an opinion on between the coalition of NASA and the Jubilee, who has the numbers, who is a social misfit here in the political arrangement. Jubilee is a social misfit in the political arrangement of Luhya land, and that's how it is. Giving you an example, Musalia ran on a party called KANU in 2002, but the wave in that region was in favor of NAC. But Musalia went against the wishes of a community. Musalia would have been a president long time before even President Kibaki. It was the wish of NAC to assign the presidential ticket to Musalia. But when he backtracked, joined the ruling party, that's how he lost the ground totally. And as a vice president of the Republic of Kenya, he was beaten by a pastor.
And so when Jubilee say that, Western is becoming a swing area, that not only do they have Ababu Namwamba, they have the likes of Governor Ken Lusaka, MPs John Waluke, Dan Wanyama, Lazarus Wafula, Boniface Otsula, etc. What do you think of that? They're not making forays?
The ones you've mentioned, compare with the ones who are still in the NASA wing. Just compare. The political bigwigs, Musalia, who controls Vihiga and part of Kakamega County, Wetangula, who controls Bungoma and Trans Nzoia, and Raila, who controls even Busia, they are all in one basket called NASA. How will this young politician manage to achieve? These are politicians who have grown. Musalia has run for presidency. Musalia has been a finance minister. Weta has been foreign affairs minister. Raila is a seasoned politician. There is no way, and we have a political assimilation between the Luhyas and the Luos. Any constituency along the border of Nyanza and Western is automatically an ODM constituency. Let me count for you. Luanda constituency, who is the MP? It borders Kisumu. Emuhaya constituency, who is MP? ODM. Funyula, you go to Budalangi, where he is still ODM. Any constituency along that line. And that assimilation has also entered somehow interior and affected areas like Butere, where the MP is ODM, Shinyalu. So the political assimilation between the Luo, the neighborhood, and the Luyas is so tight in that Jubilee cannot break in that wall.
Ababu,
and
on being a misfit.
First of all, I would take exception to the use of a word like that, because I believe that in politics, social descriptions like misfit do not really apply. Politics is a game of free choice, especially in a democracy such as this. Only a few months ago, Ayub Savula here was very cozy with a lot of the leaders in Jubilee that he's now saying are misfits, as it were. He's running all over the place with the deputy president and the others. So that kind of association would not characterize him as a misfit. It would characterize him as a person living in a free society that is absolutely at liberty to decide who to associate with. It is exactly the narrative that my brother Savula is propagating that I am arguing against. The narrative to pigeonhole people in an arrangement where you either align yourself with so and so or with this particular person, or you become, to borrow his phrase reluctantly, you become a misfit. I disagree with that. And what I want to caution my brother Savula is that, for instance, in 2002, when the wave went against Musalia, it was not a Luhya or a Luo on the NARC presidential ticket. It was Kibaki, a Kikuyu from central Kenya, mm-hmm. who was heading the NARC ticket. And so that wave was not so much about the tribe or the ethnicity of the person that was running for president. Because if it was the ethnicity, then the Luhya would not have rejected Deputy President Musalia Mudavadi to vote for President Mwai Kibaki, if ethnicity was the factor there. The factor really was a national uprising against a kleptocratic, autocratic Nyayo regime. And the whole country, it was not just about Western Kenya, the whole country desired change, and they delivered change.
And so what is it that you're predicting in this election?
What I'm predicting is that the scenario today is very different from the NARC of 2002. Right now is a contest between whether you want to associate with the politics that bring people together beyond ethnicities, beyond regions, beyond this pigeonhole, to deal with issues affecting this country, or you want to continue to engage in the politics of false hope, the politics of fault finding, and exactly this politics of saying this region can be sort of ring-fenced away from particular interests. That's the narrative we are rejecting. And I particularly want to caution my brother Savula. This narrative that was used against people like Wamalwa Kijana by the same forces, the narrative that has been used by against people like Musalia Mudavadi himself, it has been used against people like Kalonzo Musyoka. You disagree with that corner, you are a demon. Kalonzo Musyoka has been demonized at one time. Musalia Mudavadi has been demonized. Wetangula has been demonized. When Wetangula worked closely with Moi, when Wetangula worked closely with Kibaki, in a cabinet where I sat, mm-hmm. they considered Wetangula a misfit. So what I'm saying is that you must start respecting the people of Western Kenya. And you must start respecting the people of Western Kenya in the context of our freedom to associate with whomsoever we desire.
All right.
And let me finish this. This is a significant point.
We need to move on because there's something significant equally that you've already said that I wanted to latch on.
Can I just add this one?
And you talked about the narrative of negative politics, of constantly be opposing, etc. Is this what NASA does? Because
could I just add this point?
No, sir. Let's move forward.
Okay. Actually, NASA is not constantly opposing. NASA has laid down the basic principles why they want to take over power from this country. And based on the scenario in Western Province, NASA is articulating issues regarding the pan paper mills in Webuye, the factory that the president officially reopened, mm-hmm. and nothing is happening there. I neighbor pan paper Webuye. What is happening, they are using bagasse from West Kenya Sugar Company, which belongs to Rai, to manufacture tissue papers at that place. They're not even harvesting any tree. All trees are based in Lugari constituency.
Well, one line is working. Their proposal is that it was
the line that is working
is
for the bagasse. You must also post this question.
When the paper collapsed.
Look at Mumia Sugar Company.
Because not functioning.
Let me make a point and then respond.
Look at Nzoya Sugar Company. The production of sugar. The production of sugar in this country has dropped from 500,000 metric tons to less than 250,000 metric tons within a 5-year period. Look at the production of maize. We wasted a lot of money pumping billions of shillings into Galana Kulalu. Instead of supplying free fertilizers to farmers in Kitale, Lugari, in my constituency, and even your place, to produce more maize for food sustainability in this country.
And
all these are upside down. That's why I've been operating in Jubilee, because I was confined in Jubilee by my political party and I follow the law. Musalia signed an agreement with President Uhuru that we assist or we work in a coalition arrangement in parliament. I would not have rebelled against that.
Anne,
I want to respond to you on the question of the two issues
that we need to, you see, honesty is a good thing. And this politics of deceit, this politics of dishonesty, politics of the warthog, where you pretend to forget things and so you imagine that everybody else will forget.
What is the lie?
When we talk about Pan Paper, when did Pan Paper collapse and who was in power then? Because you see, the five people that have been lined up as NASA principals, one is a former prime minister. And when we look at the history of Mumia Sugar, we could easily link and draw a line of connection to where the rules of Mumia Sugar can be connected. One is a former vice president. And we know the length of time he's been part of the policies that have shaped where we are today as a country. Another one is a former long-serving minister for finance. I would want to be told what he ever did as minister for finance for all these industrial establishments we are now talking about today. The other one is a long-serving minister for foreign affairs who was also part of the Moi government for a long time. So when you tell me that these people who have been in the government for an aggregate of almost 100 years, if you add them together, and who have been part, because companies don't just collapse. Companies collapse because of an aggregate of factors. And these factors can be traced to policies, actions, that were propagated by some of these characters when they were in very senior positions of government. And so to want to take their mistakes or the product of their misdemeanors, and you want to load them on a regime that is now attempting to correct.
So you leave actually to collapse.
Wipe the floor. No, not
because
collapse.
You want to deal with history.
No, effort is being made. Savula, you and I were in Mumias when 2 billion shillings was being pumped in Mumias by President Uhuru Kenyatta himself in an attempt to save Mumias. Savula, you know, and you have talked about the narrative of how the former managers Mumias, who you are now in bed with today, how they brought down Mumias, and how much money they still owe Mumias today. If they were to pay their debts to Mumias, those fellows you are in bed with, it would be part of the solution to what bedevils Mumias today.
The solution of Mumias is not about pumping in 2 billion. Mumias currently owes Commercial Bank about 13 billion. Commercial Bank. If we drop their 2 billion, it's a drop in the ocean. Mm. Why do you salvage Kenya Airways and you abandon another major company like Mumias Sugar Company? In Parliament, I oppose the bailout of Kenya Airways. I said it must be equal. Mumias is equal to Kenya Airways. Why are we giving priority to Kenya Airways? Those are the issues we need to articulate
you
now.
You believe what the government has done in as far as reviving these sort of collapsed industries has been more lip service?
Lip service to the media community and non-substantial completely.
Okay, we need to move forward. And Savula, let me start with you on the question of numbers. How critical is the Western Kenyan bloc to the assertion of NASA leader Raila Odinga of 10 million strong? What is it that you believe you bring to the table?
I think not just the Western Kenya. In Nairobi here, Luhya is the number two in population. There are about 650,000 voters after members of the Kikuyu community. And in Western Kenya, they have about 3.6 million votes. Technically, when we calculate, we can bring around 3 point something million votes, because you know the Luhya community tends to be more democratic. You'll even find chama cha chap chap. It's called chap chap.
We'll get three or four votes.
And they are so democratic, but the majority of the votes will go to NASA.
What is the majority?
Majority is more than 70% of the voter turnout will go to NASA.
Does this have everything to do with having Moses Wetangula and Musalia Mudavadi now working together?
Politics is a matter of interest. The perception the Luhyas have is that our leaders have been accommodated in the government to be. They talk about an existing position, but positions, we go by the constitution. The constitution is for the people, and the people are the ones who make the constitution.
We can go and change the constitution after winning within 90 days. And Savula needs to be honest.
And create those positions.
What is he being dishonest
Savula
about?
Savula knows.
What does Aluya have in Jubilee?
Savula knows.
Apart from two cabinet secretaries, one married in Central,
and the other one who was appointed.
Marital issues really are not an issue here. And Savula knows that there's a very strong feeling in Western Kenya among the Mulembe community that Musalia Mudavadi and Moses Wetangula have been promised a goat's gizzards.
Okay.
They've been promised a goat's gizzards.
Something that doesn't exist.
And that is something that Savula needs to be honest about. Because talking about Sijui, Chief Watt, Premier this,
Premier
and
Cabinet
that,
Secretary.
Those are things that don't exist. Those are just fancy titles. But they don't exist. And to really say that you're going to give someone a position. In fact, someone made a very interesting comment today that Musalia Mudavadi has replaced Eliud Owalo as Raila Odinga's presidential campaign manager, because that now we are being told that Musalia Mudavadi is the manager of Raila Odinga's campaign program. The truth is that if you look at that whole NACA arrangement,
sorry,
you have a president and a deputy president. Everything else is hot air. Absolute hot air. There's nothing there. And to lie to the Luhya community that you have some position called premier, some fancy title.
Our arrangement is based on amending the constitution. That's what you don't understand.
So now you're talking about amending the constitution.
What is the hope and jubilee then? Tell us the hope. Apart from the bridge in Buralangi, and that is the constitutional right of any government.
So why didn't the previous government build it?
You were there as a minister.
It's not favors.
No, you've just it's said favors. It's your constitutional
right.
Okay,
Jamal. In Uganda, we are building from a training college, Kenya Medical Training College. But I'm saying this is the responsibility of a government to serve its people.
And so that's not a favor. Namwamba, you've been very categorical that ODM should expect to see nothing, and you have been quoted as saying the governor Sospeter Ojamong must fall. Why?
It's about performance. It's purely about performance. It's nothing personal. It's about performance, and anybody who lives in Busia knows that if ODM were an honest party, mm-hmm. I started raising these issues, remember, 3 years ago when I was deep in ODM. I raised these issues even when I was Secretary General of ODM. If ODM were honest, they would admit that a lot of the governors that have flown the ODM flag have been total failures. And Ojamong, you know, in Busia, really, mm-hmm. Will struggle to convince the people of Busia.
So you'll be back in Paul Otuoma?
Where we are going to place our support as a party will be determined by the party. Remember right now, Anne, I no longer just talk as a Babu Namwamba. Mm-hmm. When I talk, I have to talk on behalf of the Labour Party. Just like the Labour Party made a collective decision to support Uhuru Kenyatta for president, Labour Party is also consulting on where to support whoever in various other positions where we do not have.
So you're not fielding a candidate in this particular?
We have not fielded a candidate there, and the decision will be made by close of this month.
All right. As we wind up, what do you believe the political future of this region is going into the election, and in particular with Musalia Mudavadi? Because if one was to go with the agreement that is on the table for NASA, Raila has been on the record saying that he's content with one term. Thereafter, it should fall to Kalonzo. So which makes us wonder in which year Musalia Mudavadi would have a shot at the presidency if he was to remain in a NASA agreement. What is the future of the region? And do you have a horse in 2022?
Can I correct you? Actually, I've seen that agreement, and it does not specify that Kalonzo will be the next year after Raila's one term. It's open ended, which means Musalia and Kalonzo will go for nomination. My brother here was growing up in politics very well, and I was sure of supporting him if he ran for presidency in 2022 against the old guys like Kalonzo and Musalia. Should have participated in the NASA nomination and he could have gotten that ticket.
But now?
But going forward, mm-hmm. it will be a race between Musalia and Kalonzo. And based on numbers, Musalia will clinch the ticket. And we have a hope because in our arrangement in NASA, we are giving Raila 5 years. In the arrangement in Jubilee, they are giving Uhuru another 5 years. After Uhuru, they will give William Ruto, my neighbor in Turbo, another 10 years.
So you Ababu
wants to tell me that he will run for president after 15 years. How old will he be? And the world all over, the movement is that the younger generation is now taking over the leadership. Take the example of France. The president of France today is 38 years.
He's lost it, is what you're saying.
Yeah. So you've lost it completely. So you'll run for president after 15 years from today. How old will you be?
And, okay. and let us not engage in these semantics. And this is what I normally call the politics of false hope. Politics predicated on false hope. The arrangement in NASA is an arrangement of convenience. It's a marriage of convenience. Very strange bedfellows brought together purely out of a personal selfish interest in the hope that everyone can sort of elbow each other. Right now you are already seeing the game of elbowing for 2022 is starting in 2017.
But this is a game of numbers.
Yes, and so
numbers elbow the other.
This is an arrangement which in my view is driven by selfishness. It has very little to do with the best interests of this country. And what I believe, Anne, is that after August 8th, the matrix of politics always changes. It has never worked in the way that Savula or his so-called NASA team want to make it appear. The matrix of politics, the dynamics of politics always changes. And I believe the dynamics of politics will change. I believe that when President Uhuru Kenyatta wins the next election, I have every confidence that he will win the next election.
Mm-hmm. Finally.
Pardon?
Finally, sir.
I'm saying that the dynamics will change. And where
we
have chosen...
You see as inheriting this vote block?
I look forward to an opportunity to seek the highest post in this country. I look forward to that, Anne. And I do not need to belong to NASA to pursue that dream.
Let's see what Kenyans think about you inheriting your backyard, if you like. Is Ababu Namwamba the next kingpin of Luhya land? 30% saying yes, 70% saying no. That's where we're going to wind up our discussion.
30% is a good start. It's a very good start.
It's a terrible start.
No, it's a good start.
Oh my God. Well, you've got 15 years. You've got 15 years.
I've got 5 years. Musalia got less than 4% of the presidential election last time.
So
30% is a very good start. It's way ahead what Musalia got in 2013.
All right. And that's where we end up our discussion on Monday Special. My thanks to both of you for coming in. The support is up next.